evening. Thank God for these pastors, Dr. Jones and Pastor Williams, and also Dr. Frank Rain from Detroit, Dr. Carson, very thrilled, very happy, and other pastor. We certainly greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God is good and He is worthy of all my praise. Thank God for the first ladies in here. And certainly God has spoken. And it is our prayer that we accept what God has done. For He is a good God. At this time, if that's invited to review the remainder for the last time, feel free to come at this hour. And after that, then the Spirit of Director will come and close the passage. Thank you.
Thank you. church say amen? Amen. One more time, amen. God is good, and he's good all the time. So I love Pastor Dr. Jonathan Rick.
Amen.
Pastor David Williams.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The New Testament reading coming from the Gospel of John, chapter 14, beginning verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest. How can we know the way? Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Here is the news of his most righteous word. Be encouraged this morning.
Amen.
those who went in and out of those doors reminded her of what you used her to do when she was strong.
Yeah.
We thank you for her giving her life to you. She did not die in vain. She died because it was once appointed for man and women to live and then for them to die. But there's a resurrection day. So we can celebrate this service, O Lord. We can thank you for those who gathered to be a part of it. Then, gracious God, there's one who has been preaching a good part of this week. He must stand one more time. We ask that you endow our pastor, the Reverend Wright, Dr. John W. Williams. We ask that you pour out within him the power of your word. From forth your word, that your Holy Spirit reign on the people, that they will realize that this is still a worship service. It's a celebration of life, but it's a worship service. And because we are worshiping you, we are further growing in the depths of our future. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
and bring us not to the picturesque. And Father, may I be back to guide us in 2 minutes. I think about that 2 minutes.
Elder John Michael Taylor, pastor. And God shall wipe all tears from check on me and my kids. She never left my sight without telling me she loved me. She always tell me, motherfucker, she always tell me how far she was.
All right.
Son, I'm gonna let you know. You remember when you came over to my house and my hair was touching my shoulders? And you wanted me to come out with the oil that I was using? Well, I came out with it, baby, and it's booming.
All right.
It's booming. I just wish you were still here, see? I'm gonna miss you forever. All the memories, all the hitting, everything, everybody in here, if she ever got mad at y'all, I know about it.
Well,
everybody.
And you told me.
I know about it. But honey, I love you. And I'm gonna always keep you in my heart and your memories in my house.
Yeah,
all right.
all she did was just fly away.
Well,
and then this is not the only death. This one coming after this one. But we all gonna come this way. And if you're not written in the book of the Lamb of Life, what will you be? You're just gonna be flying away.
Well,
thank you, Sean. We're going to have a selection from the choir. And then after that, our pastor will be before us. He bring us a message today. And we hope your hearts are ready to receive the word of God.
Yeah.
Thank you.
host, Dr. Pastor Williams, and all of his other preachers, pastors over here, Dr. Talbot, Rev. Lane, and it's just good to be here. Today, in the celebration, the homegoing of this, our brother, our sister, and saying that all of us have to move from this old place. Thank God for the life of Sister Sundin.
Amen.
Sundin will keep you laughing.
Amen. Amen.
Whether it's 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the morning.
Amen.
And then she loved the pastor because she called him a day out with it. Tell me how much she loved her dad and mama and all of her sisters. And there are some folks in the world who don't love nobody. Because he is evil. Thank God for people who know how to love in spite of. Thank you for Sister Quinn and Brown and the members of that family who supported Sunday in her days of sickness that she could not do for herself. But others had to do for her. And people will soon forget you when you get down. But if you be kind and gentle to other people, God got somebody that will come to your rescue.
All right.
Thank God for Sister Sunday. All right. Let me talk with you for about 12 to 15 minutes. I used to just preach. I'm preaching and fishing with a goal and aim in mind. That if you're here today and not saved, what a better day to accept Christ as your Lord and Savior. To die without Christ being in your life, there is a place that they call hell. But if by chance you die in Christ, there's a place called heaven. And the streets are paved with gold. I want to talk to you from the book of Hebrews, the 9th chapter. And the 27th verse, it says that it is appointed unto man once to die, and then the judgment. And as it is appointed unto man, wants to die.
Yes, sir.
But after this, the judgment.
All right.
I'm going to talk from a little subject today from our appointment with death.
All right. All right.
Our appointment.
Yes, sir.
With death. Nobody can escape.
Maybe
see. Heaven is my goal. Yeah. your appointment with death. Death is sure to come.
Right.
The scripture says that it is appointed unto men once to die. And then after that, the judgment. Many people fear death. Because it is unknown.
Yes, sir.
But Adam and Eve sinned in the Garden of Eden. Sin got them kicked out of paradise.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
They were thrown out of paradise because they disobeyed God. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
It was not until Adam and Eve messed up that sin came into the world.
Yeah.
And out of the results of sin, death also entered into the world.
Yeah.
But Jesus the Christ bore the sin of the world.
Yes, yes.
Out on a hill called Calvary. In other words, Abraham and Adam and all the rest of the fellows could not pay for our sin.
Yes.
Jesus said in John 14, "Let not your heart be troubled." Sundown is in a better place. Now, God knows if she loved you, she would not trade places with you today. She knew that according to the obituary, she accepted Christ at an early age. Evidently, Sundown knew that this day would come. And so she made up her mind to accept Jesus as her Lord and Savior. I wish I could stand here today and tell you that we all have lived free and above sin. But is it possible for you to live in a world like this and don't commit sin?
Man, that's right.
The Bible says all have sinned. From the pulpit to the back door, all have sinned. All have missed. Is that right? All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There was a song that they used to sing, "I have not reached perfection yet, but I've tried." On your way to heaven, you're going to make some mistakes. You're going to do some things you ought not do. You'll say some things that you ought not have said. But thank God, according to 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, He's willing, He's faithful, and He's able to forgive us of our sin. Sometime in this life, sometime in sickness, one can become very irritable and tired and want to leave this earth. Sundown got tired along the way. She got tired of the doctors sending her through procedures. Sundown was ready to go home because she realized that the Lord had prepared a place for her. She said, "I'm ready to go now." You see, you can't leave from here until God called you. And God bade you want to leave. You cannot take out until God called you from labor to reward. Is that right? Sickness and trouble and problems of this life will make you want to go home. Because you realize on the other side is a better life. Jesus don't want us to be afraid of dying. Anybody who is in Christ ought not be afraid of God. I like to live a long time, but I realize that there is a better place than being here on this earth. But while I'm here, I might as well make the best of it. Because one of these days, soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. The Bible says to be absent from the body. And that's what will happen here. Sunday is not in that body. Be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Isn't that so? Faith believes what God has said.
Yes.
He said he was coming back after the church without a spot of wrinkle. Faith agrees with what God said. In other words, believe the Bible, obey the Bible, and then do what the Bible said to
you.
It's written in our heart to love people when you've been born again. The more they talk about you or me, the more we go on our knees. And help us to be able to deal with our adversaries. Isn't that so? Faith speaks what God speaks. In other words, we who are saved ought to want to do what God shall do because we have a reward waiting for us. Sunday, myself and you, ought to realize that everybody don't like us.
Yeah.
No, no. Everybody don't like you. I don't care how many friends you got.
Right.
Everybody don't like you. Once you make up your mind to stand up and live for Jesus, you're going to make some money. Galatians 4 and 16 says, "How I therefore become your enemy, because I tell you the truth."
Amen.
Now, if you want to give you some ways you can get folks out of your house and out of your business. When they come over to your house, tell them to pull out the 66 books. Next time you come, bring your Bible. Is that right? Ain't gonna be no, what do you call that? Get Henderson. Yeah, you don't see that anymore. Really, man. Yeah. Pull out the book. Joshua 1 and 8 says, this book of the law. This book of the law. Shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate upon it day and the night. Now, folks, I want to hear the truth too quick. They get up and walk out and leave you by yourself. Isn't that so? After pastoring the church for 42 years, I've seen it happen right here. The folks you see today, you won't see tomorrow. People don't want to hear the truth, but Sunday did not live like you and I thought she ought to live. But what she wanted to do was to please God. I can't please the church, and you may please your neighbor, but one person you ought to want to please, and that's God. Because all of us have an appointment with that. The Bible says there's a time and a season for every purpose and everything done under heaven. There's a time to plant, a time to pluck up. There's a time to kill, and there's a time to heal. Goodness of it. There's a time to love, and there's a time to hate anything that God hates you and I or he. Isn't that so? There's a time of war. There's a time of peace. There's a time to weep, and there is a time that we all to laugh. There's a time to mourn, and there's a time to dance. There's a time to be born, and there's a time to die. Death is an appointment. Is an appointment that we all must keep. No exception, no exemption, and no exception. This appointment must be kept.
Because the Bible says, as it is appointed unto men once to die, and after that, the judgment. I have an appointment with death. You have an appointment with death. And it's the one appointment that cannot be canceled, cannot be ignored. But there's something else after death. The graveyard, when you go to the graveyard and deposit the remain, that's not the end. No, that's not the end. The Apostle Paul says, "For we must all appear before the judgment seat, that everyone may receive the thing done in this body." You gotta be careful how you treat people. Because the book says, whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Yes, sir.
We got to learn how to be kind, gentle, and keep a smile on our face. Yeah. Sonnen was always smiling. You can look at the picture and see Sonnen smile. Isn't that good? Some folks lay down mad, sleep mad. You want to know how I know? Check the cover sometimes. The cover's all on the floor. Wrestling with the cover. Just mean and easy. But if you are born again, you can sleep even in the storm and on the outside. You got somebody, God will take care of you. Jesus Christ will either say, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord prepared for you." He will say, "Depart from me, I never knew you." You ought to make sure the Lord knows you. Something else Solomon said in Ecclesiastes 7, "A good name is better than precious ointment, and the day of death than the day of one birth." Referring to those who died in faith, is the day of one death is better than the day of one birth. And this father, King David, actually said, "O Lord, truly, I'm thy servant. I'm thy servant and the son of thy handmaid. Thou hast loosed my bond." You become a soldier in God's army. You're loosed from the devil. Precious in the sight of the Lord in the death of the saint. When a saint of God dies, they're moving up a little high. We may wonder, how can this be the death of a loved one, which bring the deepest grief of any human experience, is to God precious. Oh, brothers and sisters, God is precious. It is because death is the final separation between the children of God and our heavenly Father. It is the final barrier we all must pass through before breaking into everlasting life. Yes, and this is why death holds no fear for the children of God. I hear David saying, "The Lord is my shepherd."
Yeah.
Aren't you glad today that you got a shepherd?
Yeah.
A shepherd cares about the sheep.
Yeah.
He said, "Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death,
yeah,
I will fear no evil.
Yeah.
For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff. They comfort me."
Yeah.
So when our time comes to pass through this final exit of death,
yeah,
into the land of the living, we who trust in Christ,
yeah,
can face it without fear.
Yeah.
Now I know that most people think that this earth is the land of the living.
Yeah.
But I got news for you, that this is not really living.
No,
we're just surviving. On the other hand, when we get to the other side, we begin to live. You talking about great day? In that day, we'll have joy and peace. So let me close by saying to you, what is heaven really like? I'm glad you asked today. I want to tell you that heaven, in heaven there won't be no death. In heaven there won't be no tears. Sadness and pain, will be a thing of the past. I don't know about you, but I'm looking for that day. I'm looking for that day when the Lord and His servant will come. For in heaven, we'll be free from darkness. There won't be no night. No, in heaven. There will be a family reunion. I don't know about you, but I suppose that all of us have some roots that have died in Christ. You and I miss them down here. But one of these days, we'll have a family reunion. Oh, one time we'll be. Will y'all hear me today? Heaven will be a perfect place. It will be a place of rest. There won't be no, there will be a body changed in heaven. You will have a new mind in heaven. For old things will pass away. But I'm glad, some glad morning, when this life is over, I'm gonna fly away somewhere to be at rest. Where heaven is here. So as I close today, I wanna tell you, Jesus paid it all, and all to Him. I said He paid it all on the hill called Calvary. Yeah, they hung Him high and stretched Him wide. He hung there from the sixth and the ninth hour. It looked like it was all over, but I want to tell you, it was dark today. The sun refused to shine. They look real and rock the line. He died to tell you, but that's not the end of the story. They took him down from the cross and put him in a cold grave. But I must tell you, the grave can hold me. The fire put them, water put ground in. But I want to tell you once and more. I said once and more. You got to out of the grave and told the whole world, I got all power in heaven and earth in my hand. Thank you, Lord. Somebody knows
Nobody can do you like me.
He's a God all by himself. Give me 3 minutes and then we'll be ready for the funeral director.
Sister,
Reverend, brother, come on, read it for get a Bible and go to this Bible here.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
Somebody over here want to see no more.
That's right.
Unless there's a wedding, there's a funeral. Somebody over here.
All right.
There's a great possibility that somebody in the choir. I hope it's not so. But I won't see no more until the death. Weddings, you know, people will pack out the church for weddings and funerals. The only reason this church is not packed today is because most people are afraid of the virus. I want you to look at Genesis and tell your neighbor it's in the book. I want you to look at Genesis 24 and in verse 56. Sunday is resting. She's resting in the arms of Jesus.
Yes, sir.
All Sunday was saying, loose me and let me go. I'm tired of the doctors and the nurses waking me up at night, shooting me and giving me medicine. I got a better place to go. Watch what this says, Genesis 24. And 56.
And he said unto them, hinder me not, seeing the Lord hath prospered my way.
Hinder me not, seeing the Lord has prospered my way. Members and friends, you don't have to be afraid of dying.
Right.
And Christ is the center of your life. Jesus said in John 14, I'm going away now to prepare a place for you. And I'm coming back after you after a while.
Yes, sir. Teach now.
The end of the world is ready to be destroyed.
Yes,
what we're living under now is the dispensation of grace.
Yes, sir.
The Bible says before the end of the world, you would hear wars and rumors of wars. Sons would be against father against sons, daughters against mothers. Love will wax cold. All of this is happening right now.
All right, all right.
And all God is doing to us is giving us a chance to get right with him. Mm-hmm. If you're not right with him, you ought to do that today.
Amen.
What he said, don't hinder me. Read.
And he said unto them, hinder me not, seeing the Lord hath prospered my way. Send me away that I may go to my master.
Now, this is the time. And thank God for this family, for that behavior, how they conducted themselves.
Amen.
No matter what you do, you can't bring the son of them back.
Amen. Amen.
Nothing you say, nothing you do, would she have changed faces with either one of us.
All right.
Over yonder is better.
Yes, sir.
She ain't got to worry about nobody breaking in on her. This is what he said, loose me and let me go. Seeing that the Lord has this, read.
Send me away that I may go to my master. And
when you die in Christ, you got a place to go. Now all of us got a place to go. And that's two places. Hell or even heaven.
That's right.
And the Lord says, I set before you two roads. You choose the one you want. On the road to heaven. The fruit traveling. But on the road to hell is crowded. It's crowded. But every once in a while you meet a soldier on that road. The Bible says hell has been enlarged. That means that some people that thought they were going to heaven don't miss mark. Loose me. Let me go. What you gonna do now after we go to the cemetery? Here's what you ought to do. get out of the grieving mode.
All right.
And get into the mode of thanking God.
Yes, sir. All right.
Many children have died. I believe a baby died the other day. But some of them lived to get 40 some years, almost 50.
Yes, sir.
She made us laugh. She brought some joy.
Oh, yeah.
Don't focus on the negative thing.
Amen, amen.
But focus on the positive thing.
That's right, amen.
And if I live right, I'll see them on the other side.
Right.
Is that right? In closing. In closing. So y'all don't think I'm making this up. Read this scripture, then you get the last scripture. Joshua 1:8. Well, some folks think he's making this stuff up. You ain't got to make up nothing when you read this Bible.
That's right.
Is right here.
Yeah.
In this book, there are 66 books.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible is basic instruction for man before he leaves the earth. If you live for Jesus, you're going to make somebody angry.
Well,
I don't see no babies in here. All of us is grown now. All to know that heaven is too much to miss. If they don't like you today, Miss Queen, they won't like you tomorrow.
That's right.
I wanted everybody to love me 42 years ago. And I was the biggest fool that was. Listen, if you make one friend a lifetime, you're doing good. Joshua 1:8 said this.
This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
This, the Bible, is the law of God.
Yes.
No man wrote God. That's why Mr. Donald Trump, he keeps changing his mind. He done told so many lies that he ain't got no pass right. He wake up the mind.
That's a good point.
Is that right?
Man. This
book of the law, the Bible, is God's law. Not my law, not man's law, but God's law.
Yeah.
All right?
But thou shalt meditate therein day and night.
But thou shalt meditate day and night. You don't know what's right if you don't read the Bible.
Amen.
The book says that is a way which seemeth right unto man, but the end thereof are the ways of death.
Yes.
People need to be taught and trained. And then you need to read the Bible for yourself. So that if I said something wrong, I'm not talking about your opinion, but you show me in here. To make sure that the pastor's right. Because some people, they never read the Bible, they want to say the pastor's wrong. They look for a psalm, and the psalm is in the Old Testament. And they were way over in the New Testament. That thou shalt meditate upon the day and the night and then what else?
That thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein.
Once you know the law and run the stop sign, police give you a ticket, ain't no use to get mad.
That's right. That's crazy.
Is that right?
Yeah.
My final scripture is Luke 22:31-32. Right quick. Yeah, Luke 22:31-32.
Yes, sir. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon.
Now move Simon's name out. And put your name there.
All right.
And the Lord said, John William, all right?
Behold, Satan hath desired to have you.
Satan wants you.
Yes, sir.
He wants you. And he'll take the smallest thing and drive a wedge between you and your loved one. All right?
That he may sift you as wheat.
The final result is that Satan wants to kill you.
Yeah.
You don't have to be in a casket. You don't have to go to the cemetery. He can kill your joy.
That's right.
You may even walk around and hate people for no reason at all.
Yeah.
You have a pocket full of money and be miserable. Some of us in here got a pocket full of money, but you can't go to sit down to the restaurant. Money, you can't buy a seat in heaven. Money can't get you healed. Money can't give you appetite. But Jesus can do it all. And that's why I want to say to you today that Satan has a desire to sift you as wheat. Listen, just don't take long. You're going to accept Christ, you're going to accept it. If you're not, you ain't going to accept it. Listen.
It's another day's journey, and I'm glad.
Of those who sleep in him shall be changed. and made light unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Thus we come now as the pallbearers come and get ready.